an FPV drone from DJI. Is it finally here? Will this work for the Chinese company, who was so established in the camera drone market? Find out more in today's video.
Geeksvana is your drone channel, providing news, reviews, flights, interviews, and much more.
Hey everyone, welcome to Geeksvana. Today we're going to be discussing some very exciting news from the drone world. It appears DJI are finally getting themselves into the FPV market. If you're new here, please consider subscribing. And to get the latest drone news first, hit the notification bell. So what is this new FPV product? And where is this information coming from? Well, let's get straight to it. Whenever a product is released for the United States market, which uses a radio frequency, it requires an FCC grant, which the manufacturer will apply for prior to production starting. There is often a lot of secrecy around it to protect that company's commercial interests to ensure their product is not leaked before they launch their own marketing. This case is no different. DJI have three grants listed with the FCC, each of which has a 45-day secrecy period. The timing of the grants and this grace period leads us to believe that we could be seeing a September release for the product. Why do we think this release will be FPV related? Well, that is down to the titles of the grants themselves, listed as 1. DJI FPV Goggles, 2. DJI FPV Air Unit, and 3. DJI FPV Remote Controller. For more evidence, let's take a look at the individual documents to show what is being launched. Firstly, the DJI FPV Goggles. Here you can see a list of available exhibits, which were provided to the FCC by DJI in order to gain the grant. Again, a lot of the interesting information is protected. There are no real pictures, etc. to help us. However, they have included the FCC ID label. This label shows a general shape to the internals of the goggles where the label itself will fit. I'm sure DJI would have been careful to make this label a different shape to the final product, so this probably isn't an indication of how the goggles will look. Interestingly, for the European market, there is a CE marking, so this looks like a worldwide release rather than a limited one as with the DJI RoboMaster product. Next up is the DJI FPV Air Unit. Again, there is limited information here in terms of the product itself, but we do again have an ID label to inspect. You can see that the label will be positioned on part of the camera setup, so DJI have had to show this in the ID label picture. The label is clearly marked as DJI FPV Air Unit, and again there is a European CE marking here. And third and finally, the DJI FPV Remote Controller, which again shows a label confirming what the product is and its location, which appears to be in the battery pay perhaps. So what does all this mean? It appears we have a major move by the biggest name in world drones into the FPV market. This will be very interesting, as there is a lot of loyalty in the niche to several established brands who know their customers extremely well and provide some excellent customer service, often developing products specifically requested by their client base. DJI, on the other hand, do not necessarily have the best name in customer service. However, in general, when they enter a marketplace, they tend to do it in such a way as to assure their own success. Look at the action camera market with their very first DJI product, the Osmo Action, taking the sector by storm, instantly placing DJI as one of the leaders in the sector. What type of FPV drone will it be? Will this be more of a toy or a serious FPV requiring the user to engineer and build it from parts? Certainly, if you look at the RoboMaster, DJI are not afraid of providing the user with a bit of a challenge. Could this be a drone to go under the worldwide 250-gram regulations? This would make this product exempt from even the new product rules coming in next year in Europe. It would make the new FPV drone extremely popular with children and amateur drone enthusiasts. One thing for sure is, as soon as there is any more information, we'll bring it to you straight away. So please remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell.
Please remember to like and subscribe.